Hey guys, I'm Pascal from Orange Pixel, and today is another update video on Gunslug, and I'm very pumped for this video because I think I say this every time, but this time a lot has changed, only for the better, of course, because the game is getting better and better every day. And if you follow me on social media, you've probably seen all these changes already on Twitter or Facebook or something. But today I wanted to talk a little bit more about why I made certain decisions, why I started adding stuff, and basically the behind the scenes of my game development and my ideas and why I do things. And I hope that's really the reason you're here watching this video, watching this channel, because that's basically what these videos are about. So today we're going to talk about Gunslug and all the changes I made since the last update, which was about 4 weeks ago. So maybe I'm going to do this every month until the game is released, which is hopefully not a lot of months from now, but it should still be a few months away from now. So let's do this video very quickly so I can get back to the game. Alright, so let's talk about Gunslug and the new changes since the last video. It's been 4 weeks, I just checked the recent video, and if you don't know what Gunslug is, you should also check the recent video up on it. It's called the devlog for Gunslug. I don't have it on my screen right now, but it's something like that. Last time I talked about graphics, redoing all the background graphics and things like that. Those are now done for at least 4 out of the 5 worlds, but I'm not really sure if I'm gonna keep the 5th world, which is the Hell World, but I don't know if Hell World still fits in the game, so I'm not redoing it until I'm really sure it's gonna be in the game, because else it's just a waste of time. So visually, everything is now pretty much updated, and also a lot of new gameplay features are added, which is really the main thing I wanted to talk about today. So one of the biggest features, and I've been really working my ass off not to add this, was an inventory screen. I wanted to find a way to just not have an inventory screen in the game, make things work without having to sort through your items and stuff like that. But in the end, I just had to cave into this idea because it didn't work. Some items are instant, other items you wear, so those items are fine without an inventory. But at some point I wanted to add items that just don't function well in the game without having an inventory and the player being able to pick them manually. So I ended up with an inventory screen. Right now it's just a draft. It might end up in the final game. I might completely change it or redesign it. I'm not sure yet, but at least there's some functioning of an inventory screen. So now I can at least test if all these items work. So the way I've set up the inventory is that basically you have only 2 hands and you can only hold 1 item with it. So you either hold your weapon, a melee or ranged weapon, or an item. Which is an interesting thing, because an item like the EMP, which sends out a signal or beam or something that disables all the computers and robots around you, is great to use in areas with laser beams and things like that, and robots. Of course, you now have to forfeit carrying a weapon. You can still switch pretty easily and pretty quickly to a weapon, but that will put your EMP back in your inventory, and the robots will come alive again. So that makes it a little bit of a tactical decision, and I'm gonna add more of those type of items. So that really should give you the option of, am I gonna use this item or am I gonna use my weapon? Which is the better option? And I want the player to have those kind of options. It's a pretty open game. You can tackle things in your own way. You can just go in shooting with your weapon, or you can sneak around and you can use your items, and it's up to the player, but at least there is now an option for the player. So the inventory screen is added, and we'll see how it transforms in the next few weeks or months until release. But I also added a lot of things in respect to stealth and tactical stuff. So right now you can sneak up to enemies from behind and you can stab them, which was already in the game. But you can also take them down, and then their bodies lay on the ground, and then you can pick up that body and drag it around and throw it down a cliff, and other enemies will notice that body and will focus on the body. Then you can attack them from behind, and it opens up a lot of new features which I can now think about, and we'll see where it takes us. And still there is more. You can drag bodies, you can take down enemies, but there is more to do than just interacting with enemies. I also added options inside the tower or inside the buildings. There are now objectives. So one of the objectives is sabotage rockets. The enemy has rockets and they want to launch it, and you don't want them to launch it. So there are now rockets that you can go to, and there's a console in front of those rockets. You can hack it, which takes a little bit of time, and it will also start alerting enemies around you. So you need to make sure that either there are no enemies there, they can't get to you, or you're very fast in hacking, which will be one of the character properties. So some characters will be much better at hacking, or it might also be a skill that you can evolve. So eventually all characters could be better at hacking, we'll have to see how that works out. But for now, sabotaging stuff is in the game. Besides that, there's also hacking consoles, which are normal consoles without a rocket behind them. There are hostages you can rescue, so right now they're just random rescues. But in tradition of Gunslugs, it could also be that you have to unlock characters that way by eventually having a mission that you need to unlock a certain character or save a certain character, and it will be a new character you can pick in the game. Something like that. At least sabotage, hostages and hacking is in. There are more things I wanted to add, and right now there are things like lasers moving about, so maybe there will be like a switch you can flip and then the lasers will be off, or you need something to... I don't know yet where this is gonna end, but we're gonna add more objectives because I'm also thinking about adding missions to the game, and those missions would need objectives to make a bigger variation in the game. So a lot of stuff is going on in my head, and luckily I'm also writing down a lot of stuff because else my head could explode. I'm not sure if that ever happened to anybody, but it could explode. So I'm writing down these things as well, and I'm recording them on video, so there's a lot of backups. A few weeks ago, a few months ago, I also talked and showed the creation of the new status bar for Gunslugs. It was going from this little silly simple status bar into this cool graphical status bar. And that status bar is gone now. I noticed that when I was playtesting the game, I didn't really look at status bar because there was just too much going on in the corner. Everything was there, it was too tiny, it was too cramped up, and it wasn't really a quick look at the status bar to know where I was or how the game was going or how I was with my life and energy and weapons and them. So I completely rearranged stuff. Right now you'll see the health bar in the top corner, but it's a lot bigger with a big number because that's really the only thing you need to know. How much lives do I have left? At the center of the screen there will be the inventory or the current item in your hand, which is really also the most important thing to know about, because if you're gonna stab someone and you have a tennis ball in your hand, it's not gonna work. So you really need to know, what am I carrying? That is the main thing you need to know. And then on the right side there will be coins. I'm still mixing things around a little bit, but for now it gives a much clearer view of the status bar, but not just for the player, also for people watching you play. The status bar is completely being changed, and that's actually what I'm working on today. So I'm wrapping up the video in a bit because I need to finish the status bar and get going on all the other stuff that I have, because there's a lot more stuff that needs to be done. I mean, like a lot of stuff. There is still so much I want to add to the game. It's just mind-blowing sometimes. Right now, the main thing I'm still worrying about or thinking about, or not worrying, more mostly thinking about, is how I'm gonna structure the levels and the worlds and the missions. I don't think I want the normal world level thing. No, I don't want that. I'm thinking about having missions, and one mission would unlock other missions and other areas and something like that. So for example, you would start in a training mission. Once you complete it, two new missions open up in the city. Once you complete one of those or both, I'm not sure yet, like I said, it's still a bit vague, but it would unlock missions in the jungle, and then it would unlock missions Arctic, and you could still play the city missions because there would still be some random missions there. Something like that. The structure is slowly shaping up in my head, and I figure it out. I haven't really fully... Whenever I do, I'll let you know, because it's gonna be an interesting thing and I want to see how players react to it. So also, talking about players, if you eventually want to have your hands on a beta version of this game, I do plan to do a beta version for the PC at least, eventually probably iPhone and Android, but first of all it's going to be PC, and I plan to do it on the Discord. I've been working a lot on the Discord channel. It's now a verified server, so you can just go to discord.gg/orangepixel. You can go there, hang out, idle there, and just... most of the people there are friendly. Some are a bit... I'm not naming names, but some are a bit... Most people in the Discord are pretty friendly, so just hang out there and have some fun in the community. And I also post updates there and little videos and things, what I'm working on. And I'm usually there during the day, European daytime, so that's... figure time zones. And no word on the publisher yet, which is also still a big thing. I'm giving it one or maybe two more weeks, and then I'm really gonna decide. I had one or two publishers that already responded. They are not interested, which is fine, and I'm gonna do a whole video on that and what I'm looking for in a publisher and why publisher might not be interested in this game, because I obviously know why they are not interested. It's not very difficult, but I'm gonna do a whole video on that because I had a lot of people asking me questions about it. So there's gonna be a video on publishers, even if I don't get a publisher or if I do get a publisher, it doesn't matter. I'm gonna talk about it, and I think that covers everything for this week. Yeah, I think that's it. Yeah, so I'm gonna go back working on the status bar for Gunslugs and all the other things that I still need to do. Which is so much. Like, a lot. Anyway, that's it. I'll see you guys next week. Bye. World level. World level. World level. World level. World level. World level. World level.